Hello guys, it's me, Sardan Apostol. So in this video, we are going to discuss the percentile of ungrouped data. So percentile are values that separates a set of data into 100 equal groups. So ang ginagamit natin dito to represent a percentile, we have P sub 1 o first percentile, P sub 2, second percentile, and so on papunta sa P sub 99, which is the 99th percentile. So, pag in-interpret natin to, yung ating percentile, yung P sub 1 or yung first percentile means that 1% of the data falls below the first percentile. And yung 99% above the first percentile. And yung P sub 99 or 99th percentile means that 99% of the data falls below the 99th percentile. And yung 1%, siya yung nasa above ng P sub 99 or 99th percentile. So, in solving for the percentile, gagamitin natin itong formula na to, which is P sub K is equal to K over 100. Kasi nga percentile means dinivide niya yung datas in 100, kaya over 100. Then, times the quantity of n plus 1. Then, yung th dito, kasi ang kinocompute natin sa formula is the position of the percentile. So, where k is the percentile, kung pang ilang percentile yung hinahanap. And n is the total frequency or yung total number of the frequency or data sa isang observation. So, let's have these examples. Okay, example number 1. Find the 30th percentile given the scores of 9 students in statistics quiz. So we have the scores as 45, 38, 35, 29, 54, 54, 43, 42, and 38. So para ma-solve natin yung 30th percentile, ang unang-una natin gagawin is to arrange the scores in ascending or descending order. So kung ano yung gusto nyo, so, in this example, ang gagawin natin ay ascending or from least to greatest. So, i-arrange natin. So, yun yung first step natin. So, we have the least is 29. So, that is 29. Sunod sa 29, we have 35. Then, after 35, we have 38. So, dalawang 38. Okay. Next, after 38, we have 42. Okay, after 42, we have 43. Then after 43, we have 45. Then, dalawang 54. Okay, tignan natin kung 9 pa rin yung nakuha natin datas. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9. So, we have 9 data. So, ito yung arrangement. Okay, after arranging, so, next is to solve for the 30th percentile. So, gagamitin natin yung formula. So, isolve natin yung position ng 30th percentile. So, ang formula natin ay P sub K is equal to K over 100 times the quantity of n plus 1. Since position yan, may th tayo dito or pwedeng rd and st. So, depende yan kung anong makukuha natin position. Yung k natin dito, kung ano yung percentile na hinahanap. So, let us identify kung ano yung k. Since 38 percentile yan, yung k natin ay equal to 30. And yung n natin ay yung total number of frequency. Since 9 students yon, so yung n natin dito ay 9. So let us calculate the 30th percentile. So substitute the values. So that is P sub 30 is equal to K, which is 30. Then over 100 times n, which is 9. So 9 plus 1. Then, th. Okay? So, solve muna natin yung nasa parenthesis. So, we have 30 over 100, then 9 plus 1, that is 10. Then multiply natin yung 10 sa 30, so that is 300. So 300 divided by 100. So ang magiging sagot natin dyan, yung position ng percentile 30 ay 300 divided by 100, that is 3rd. So yung position ng percentile 30 natin, or yung 38th percentile, ay 3rd dito sa ating arrange datas. So ito yung 1 natin, 2, 3. So ang percentile 30 natin ay 38. So therefore, yung percentile 30 is 38. Okay, so kung i-interpret natin itong 38th percentile natin na 38, so ang interpretation natin dyan ay 30%, kasi nga percentile 30, so meaning kung ano yung percentile na hinahanap, ayun yung percent na nasa below siya. Okay, 30% of the scores are 38, isama natin yung percentile 30 or below. Okay? So kasama yung 38 sa ating scores. So pwede kasing possible na may 38 rin na score sa 30% of the data. Okay? So example number 2. Find the 20th percentile of the following data. So we have 27, 29, 20, 28, 25, 25, 23, 30, 28, and 24. So meron tayong 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So 10 datas. So again, to find the 20th percentile, ang gagawin natin is to arrange it into ascending or descending order. So since ang ginawa natin sa first example ay ascending, so ascending na rin natin i-arrange. So let us arrange this in ascending order. So number one step is to arrange. So ano yung pinakamaliit nating value? So we have 20. So sulat natin yung 20. Okay. Next, after 20, we have 23. Then after 23, we have 24. Okay. Next, 24. Dalawang 25. Next, we have 27. Next, we have 28. So, dalawang 28. Okay. Then, next, we have 29. And last is 30. So, tignan natin kung 10 yan. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So, tama yung arrangement natin. So, after arranging the data in ascending or descending order, so, gagamitin na natin yung formula. So, to find for the percentile, ang gagamitin natin ay P sub K is equal to K over 100 times N plus 1. Then, TH. Kasi nga, position yung ating i-compute. So, solve na natin. Since ang hinahanap ay 28th percentile, yung K natin ay 20. So, that is P sub 20 is equal to 20 over 100. Then, N is 10. So, 10 plus 1. Then, TH. Okay? So, simplify natin yung nasa parenthesis, that is 10 plus 1. So, that is 20 over 100. Then, that is 11. Then, 20 times 11, that is 220. Then, divided by 100. So, ang position ng ating 28th percentile ay 220 divided by 100, that is 2.2. So, nasa gitna ng 1, 2. So, dito nasa gitna ng 23 and 24. So, andito sa gitna niya yung position ng ating 28th percentile. Now, kung makukuha natin ay decimal, so ang gagawin natin dito ay yung linear interpolation. Again, gagamitin natin ay linear interpolation. So, ang formula para makuha natin yung exact value ng 28th percentile ay percentile or 28th percentile is equal to yung lower value. Ano tong LV, lower value? So, yung lower value, ito yung ating value sa dalawang numbers na nag-focus tayo. Kung saan nasa gitna yung ating 28th percentile. So, yung lower value dito, yung 23. Plus the decimal value. Yung decimal value naman, yung decimal na na-compute natin sa ating position. Okay? Then, times the difference ng higher value. So, yung higher value natin ay 24 minus lower value. So, ito yung formula ang gagamitin natin para ma-compute natin yung exact value ng ating 28th percentile. Okay, substitute natin yung lower value. So, yung lower value dyan yung 23. So, that is 23 plus, ano tong decimal value? Yung decimal value, yung decimal na na-compute nating position. So, yung decimal dito ay yung 0.2. So, that is 0.2. So, plus 0.2 times higher value, which is 24, minus lower value, which is 23. So, simplify natin yung nasa parenthesis. So, that is 23 plus 0.2. 24 minus 23, that is 1. So, 1 times 0.2. So, that is 23 plus 0.2. 23 plus 0.2. So, yung exact value ng percentile or 28th percentile natin ay 23.2. So, yung percentile 20 natin ay 23.2. Okay? Kung i-interpret natin to, so that is 20. So, 20%. 20% of the data falls below 23.2. So, I hope natuto kayo sa ating video on how to compute or locate the percentile of ungrouped data. Thank you for watching this video and see you on our next upload. God bless to all of you.